Senator, right now, based on your hearings, no, the DENR says they don't vote. They have no voting rights with the PAMBI, and the members of the PAMBI are more than 100 barangay officials. So very political ang composition ng PAMBI. That's number two. So it's mostly dominated by local interests, the DENR says. And number three, some of the lots are titled, where Captain Speak was put up, and they also name another resort. Ano ba ito? Itong Sagbayan Peak, it's also titled. So what needs to be changed then? The DENR says they have no voting power.
The DENR, the regional director, who also heads the EMB, meaning the Environment Management Bureau, is under the region. I mean, there are two regional directors of the Environment Management Bureau and the regional executive director. There's also a regional director of the Mines and Geosciences Bureau. Let's go to the head of the PAMBI. Number one, hindi po daan-daan ang miyembro ng PAMBI. Maybe a dozen, but there are the local officials, academe, NGOs, and the DENR as chair must preside all over it and must ensure that the management plan is done according to the law, because they're the implementing agency for that. Now, titled land, that is allowed because, as I said, before 2018, when the expanded NIPAS law was legislated, na isa batas po ito, may mga tao na po. May mga nagpatitulo na po. May mga prior rights. Yan po ay dinirespeto ng batas. However, even if you have a title to the land, the way you treat the land, yung paggamit po ng lupa ay dapat sang-ayon sa batas. And even if some areas are designated as A and D, ano bang ibig sabihin yan? Alienable and disposable. It does not mean that you can do everything and anything para baliwalain ang kalikasan ng lugar. Why are protected areas important? Because these are perhaps a source of water. These are vulnerable areas that protect the people in that area. These are unique seascapes and or landscapes. Some are UNESCO
recognized. Yes, the Chocolate Hills.
UNESCO Geopark. So, ito po ay mga mahalagang lugar. O ulitin ko, hindi lang sa ating mata, kundi para sa ating kalusugan, sa ating pang-araw-araw na buhay. So, these laws mean our very own survival.
Okay.
And even if you have a title to a land, before the law was legislated, there are certain rules in the implementation of whatever activities or projects are within the protected area.
So, Senator, who is to be made accountable? So, ang tanong, with Sagbayan Peak and Captain's Peak in Bohol, wherein a portion of the mountain had to be chopped off, right? Or areas of the mountain so that they could build these resorts. Who is accountable for the fact that, you know, to build a resort, Senator, alam natin, hindi naman yan overnight.
Exactly.
So you're talking about months and months of construction materials coming in, hindi sila humihinto. Who is accountable for this?
Number one, the PAMBI, the Management Bureau chaired by the DENR. As you said, it's not just one overnight, one day.
Yeah.
So when the chair was out of town, makikita po niyo yung plano, yung pinag-usapan po. And when the PAMBI and the chair sees that nakikita po na yung plano ay hindi sang-ayon sa batas, isa puso niya at dapat sasabihin niya ang DENR ay hindi sang-ayon sa planong ito. Kaya mananagot po kung sino po ang desisyon. Sa PAMBI, pangalawa, of course there are building permits, right? From the LGUs.
Yeah.
Sagutin po nila. And with regards to the resort in Chocolate Hills in Bohol, there is no environment clearance certificate. Aside from the go signal of the Protected Area Management Bureau or the PAMBI under the INIPAS law, aside from building permits and other permits from local government units, before the resort operates, an ECC must be granted. In this case, no ECC was given to the Captain Peak Resort. So, may mga violations po, but even then, we have to look back, and this must be a lesson learned for the DNR, for local governments to follow the law to the letter, for a clearer and better understanding of the intent of the law, even if the area is titled, even if parts of the protected area are considered alienable and disposable.
Okay. So, Senator, the problem that we have is the DENR secretary changes every 6 years, right? So, tinatayo yung resort na yun, let's presume maybe 10 years ago, 15 years ago, and clearly without an ECC, the DENR secretary then and the team then just let it be. There was no checking regarding the building of the resort. Walang tao na pumupunta doon to check the protected areas themselves. What can we do to institutionalize the protection of protected areas?
Karen, very good question. And the answer is so clear. That is the reason why there are laws. The institutionalization of all these policies to regulate activities in protected areas are enshrined in the law. I wish I could read, if you give me an hour next time, may I read every element of the law, every provision that we wrote. I have a hard copy here. Every definition of terms, every of the 94 protected areas were studied. And before they were legislated, there were studies of the DNR. There was a presidential proclamation. So, yes, the officials implementing it may change every 6 years, every 1 year. The local officials are changed, elected every 3 years. What is the constant? The law. That's why the law is so important.
But the problem, like I wanted to ask you, Captain Speak, it's been there, they've been receiving tourists, the law is there, but they are operating without an ECC.
Kaya nga po mali, kaya dapat sinara at sinara na nga. And we have to look at many more other protected areas. First, may titulo daw. I don't know, I have not checked it. Uh-oh. Second, they were given a permit daw
by the mayor and kasi the LG. Naman, hindi ka makapagpapatayo, Senator.
Yes. So clearly they did not understand or interpret the law in favor of enhancement and protection of nature and biodiversity. But they were operating without an environment clearance certificate. And before that, environmental impact assessment must also be done. So all of these processes are important because you may get one PAMBI clearance, but you don't have the ECC. But why is it there? Why was it allowed in several months to be set up and to be operational?
But Senator, I wanted to ask you, since it's a protected area, what's the process? Let's say I own the land, I pitch the resort. Shouldn't there be experts to say, okay, if you build a resort, it should be, I'm not sure, I'm not building one, but Senator, considering it's a protected area, shouldn't there be an agency that's actually guiding and watching every step until a resort is finally built? Not just the LGU, because the mayor wouldn't be an expert, right? The mayor may not necessarily know
definitely
bad for the environment. So should there be a better, I don't know, mechanism so that business and protection can go hand in hand?
Yes. As I said, it's not just the mayor or the barangay captain who are members of the Protected Area Management Bureau. That's why the DENR is a chair. That is why accredited people's organizations and NGO and academic institutions are represented in the PAMB. That's why there should be a process, you're correct, a consultation with the resident population. There's a long process. So they went through that. So something went wrong somehow because we in Manila suddenly saw a drone shop and saw them there. So sino, walang bahala eh. They just didn't care. It was terrible. It's terrible. Yes. How many more are like this? So it's important that we... I wish I could read all the terms of the law.
Senator, is there anything that needs to be changed when Secretary Loizaga said that DENR cannot vote? What do you make of that response? It's like, pag binoto ng PAMB yan, we have no voting power. That seems a bit odd, but I wanted to ask, do you need to change anything there? Does the DENR, they have to be given a vote?
Let me just review the implementing rules and regulations because laws are general policies.
Yes.
The implementing rules and regulations are the details, how it's implemented. Yeah. The PAMB, as I said, is composed of many people from different fields, and the DENR chairs it. At the end of a day, we cannot say that the DENR is powerless because the DENR chairs the Protected Area Management Board. The chair can very well say, no, this is not aligned with enhancement of biological diversity. No, this is a UNESCO geopark. No, I do not think an environment clearance certificate will be granted for this. No, I think this will deface the Chocolate Hills. No, I mean, I can.
So, Senator, what's your reaction when Secretary Loizaga said, minsan absent ang DENR sa hearing because there are so many events or duties, minsan walang representative daw ang DENR in those hearings?
Well, that is the duty of the regional executive director. It's not an easy job, definitely, but everything and anything that happens in that region is the responsibility, and to a certain extent, they have accountability for the implementation of laws. So the Region 7 executive director, the RED at the time, is responsible. And looking, moving forward, we must ensure that they know their duties. Meron bang mga tinatanggal na bundok dyan? So now it is temporarily closed. And that's just one protected area of the 94. I am certain that in each protected area, there could be violations. So we must look into that. But I will look into the IRR. But then again, we cannot just keep on giving reasons why laws are blatantly violated in this country, whether it's the ecological solid waste management, where people throw solid waste anywhere they wish, where even the Clean Air Act is violated, the Climate Change Act. Honestly, and I'll be very blunt here, in this country, a friend of mine who's an environmental lawyer told me one day when he was venting, he said, ang problema sa bansang ito eh, ang mga environmental laws, parang recommendation lang o suggestion eh, hindi pinapatupad. So really, I, as four-term senator, will exercise more strictly now the oversight function of Congress, of the Senate, in all environmental laws to ensure that all the policies that will protect us, 110 million Filipinos, will be implemented. Hindi madali. Okay.
Senator, do we need another agency that just focuses experts, but they just focus on protected areas, meaning it's a funded agency. They give the last approval. They study the areas. They take care of the areas. They monitor the areas. Other than the DENR, the DENR, of course, is concerned with so many other things, right? Senator, you have mining, you have rivers, etc. But specifically for this law, do we need an agency?
We have the regional director under DENR. We have another bureau under the DENR, Biodiversity Management Bureau, that also takes care of protected areas. And we have so many people, many of them qualified, many of them with technical expertise and scientists and wisdom and knowledge and experience. It's difficult to explain. I'm not in their position, but I would like to call them to a room aside from an open hearing and really find out. I would like to call the mayor, the barangay captain, those who approved it then, and really try to understand the logic of their thinking. Why in their judgment that it was the right thing to do at the time. But if the DNR thinks it was right then why would they close it now? So they agree with us na mali. Yeah. Because first of all, walang ECC eh.
Yeah. But the problem nga ma'am, nagpapalit ang secretary ng DENR.
That's why there is a law. Regardless of who sits there, she or he must abide by the law. Regardless of who sits there as barangay captain or mayor or whoever is the NGO representative, must abide by the law.
Yeah.
So perhaps a clearer understanding, and also how do you simplify, operationalize? Ito ang mahigpit na pinapagbawal. Ito lang ang pwedeng gawin. Ang protection,
that doesn't seem to be clear. Like that captain speak, right? It's alienable and disposable. But even aesthetically and the size, that's not the kind of resort you would imagine in Chocolate Hills, right?
They must not just close it, but really just delete it.
Delete it. Because of the size, the color. I mean, and the idea, it keeps expanding. You would think that they would be smaller, sustainable resorts.
Karen,
diba?
Sustainable use of areas in protected areas is allowed because there are strict protection zones, and there are also multiple use. As I said, there are titled lands, there are those which are considered alienable and disposable, and certain activities are allowed, except of course extractive activities. Bawal dyan ang quarrying, ang mining, bawal dyan ang mga fossil fuel na power plants, etc. However, pwede naman ang activities na sustainable, but not of that kind. I want to say words, but something stopping me from saying the words I want to use.
Okay, all right. I'm going to go very quickly with some other areas that have been discovered. We can talk about this at another time at length. For example, yung Socorro Bayanihan Group, the alleged cult in Surigao del Norte, 2004. The Protected Area Community-Based Resource Management Agreement, itong PAC Brahma, that's the illegal instrument entered into by the DENR. So they gave it to those living there to conserve the land for 25 years, but then it became a whole town, right? So isa yun, ngayon binabawi ng DENR. And then Masungi is a whole other issue, but let's start first with ito, yung sa Surigao del Norte. The mayor knew about it, all the local officials knew that alleged cult grew. Then they started building more and more. Yun ang tanong ko, Senator. Parang iba-iba in different areas.
Yes. Community-based and community-managed protected areas is important, because we need to have the engagement of the local communities. The local communities can be indigenous peoples. The local communities can be the rural villagers.
Uh-oh.
But as I said, there are policies and rules on what activities can be done. There are policies and rules on what structures can be built. And they I have not been to that area, and all I know is what transpired during the hearings. It seems like there was an abuse also of the agreement with the DENR. So there's a lot of marami pong dapat imbestigahan tungkol sa mga nakaraan para hindi na maulit ng muli ang mga agreements na pinapasukan ng DENR para po suriin natin din ang pagpapatupad ng mga grupo, mga NGO, people's organization, at mga pribadong sektor na pinapasukan ng agreement ng DENR.
Okay, so ma'am, considering we've only talked partly about two, do you think the DENR, and I'm not talking about this DENR, not Secretary Loizaga's administration alone, but frankly speaking, in this country, is the DENR doing its job? Can it do its job, or it lacks the power, the manpower, the funding, expertise? Because why can't it do it better through the years?
I have a bill to empower an enforcement bureau of the DNR so that they will be able to implement our laws better. Yeah, it's a pending measure. In the meantime, that this is not enacted into law. In short, dapat meron silang puwersa para manghuli, para i-uphold yung ating batas. It's not yet a law. In the meantime, we have to make do with existing laws, and it cannot be said that there are no funds because we in Congress allow them to make the amendments. We support them in terms of the national budget. Of course, budgets are never enough, and we would say personnel are never enough. Mm-hmm. But then again, that's not a reason for the unabated exploitation of our natural resources, which is bringing our very own survival at risk. We cannot abuse nature the way we are doing it now. Parang walang batas eh. Sometimes I feel that some people just look the other way. It's either complete ignorance or lack of understanding of the laws, or they look the other way, or corruption, or all of the above.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So on another note, I want to ask you about Masungi Geo Reserve. And I think the question on everyone's mind is, what is the future of Masungi Geo Reserve? So there's an issue. The DENR has said that the contract between Masungi Geo Reserve Foundation and their contract to conserve the area was void from the very beginning. That's what the DENR said. The DENR said there is no such thing as an endless contract, right?
In perpetuity.
Yes. So what's the future, Senator? You have this foundation that the civil society says is doing a good job, and yet they have a questionable contract. What happens now?
I would like to help them because I've not been there and I intend to go there soon. I wish you could join me to see the good work they're doing, because I've read it, I've seen it on video, and it could be a model for sustainable development for other activities within protected areas. The legalities have to be looked into. I was not privy to the internal processes at the time when the late Secretary Gina Lopez signed the agreement. There is an issue, I believe, on that agreement. And the Department of Justice has also given its own opinion on that 2017 agreement. So setting that aside, and that would be a legal issue between the proponents, and that is the Masungi Geo Reserve Foundation and the DNR and the DOJ's opinion. The opinion may be part of the MOA or the whole MOA. I still have to read it, although I've read portions of it. So setting aside the legal issue, the proponents or the foundation must also abide by laws because it is part of the Upper Marikina Protected Area. That's part of the 2000 18 legislated protected areas. Batas po yon. So the foundation managing should also, just like Captain Speak, follow and do repertorial functions as all activities and proponents in protected area. However, what they're doing, if it's good, and from what I see, there are sustainable tourism activities that do not contravene with nature, which is aligned with nature, it could also be good models for other protected areas. So there are many discussions that need to be held. I would suggest that the proponents or the board of trustees or those managing the ecotourism activities and the protection and conservation of the more than 2,600, I believe, protected area Masungit Reserve, which is so important, have a serious legal discussion with the hierarchy, the secretary, the lawyers of the DNR, because it was inked, it was signed in a different administration. At the same time, to include the Department of Justice, if there needs to be, just assuming that according to the Secretary of DNR, from what I heard during our hearing on Zoom, it was invalid, ab initio from the beginning, assuming that's correct, I still have to read the agreement, there should be a discussion, a meeting of the minds, so that they can continue under a new valid agreement, assuming the agreement was not valid. But it's not for me to decide that. I am speaking based on just what I heard during the hearing and things I've read, because I have to read all the documents that have been given me and to also encourage all of them to talk to each other. Mag-usap, sayang naman i-baliwala, isa walang bahala ang magandang ginagawa. Alam natin ang ibang mga protected areas inaabuso. Alam natin hindi sustainable ang pag-develop ng mga ibang protected areas. Ito, maaring modelo at sa aking kaalaman, maganda at magaling at mukhang may puso ang mga namamahala dito. Kung merong bang legal infirmities yung pinasukan na agreement, ay dapat mag-usap at isaayos. Pero dapat lahat may repertorial. Dapat may transparency sa management plan, sa mga activities, sa mga ginastos, sa mga kinikita. Dahil ito ay public land. Ang may-ari nito ay ang Filipino people, ang Republic of the Philippines.
Very good point, that end part where you said there has to be transparency with their cost and also the income, because it is owned by the Philippine government. Now, another pitch just quickly on Masungi is the possibility that there's a piece of land there that the BJMP wants to put up either the head office of a new prison site, kasi kulang na nga tayo ng space, right? For jails. What do you make of that?
I know that in a previous administration, a title was given to the Bureau, to the BUCOR, the Bureau of Corrections. Okay? So that's a legal document. That's a title. And if that information is accurate, then the BUCOR legally owns that. However, kung ako ang BUCOR, please naman po, huwag kayo magtayo dyan ng anumang gusali. Maaring pag-aari ninyo, ibalik na nyo sa Republic of the Philippines at gawin na lang yung conservation. Please lang. Hindi naman lahat ng napatituluhan ay tama. That was done during the president, to the time, I think, of President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. For what reason, I am not familiar. But I know there was a presidential declaration. So I understand that they are no longer planning to move there. I think it would be foolish for them to move there. Let the title remain if they own it. But remember, the BUCOR is government. That's still the Republic of the Philippines.
Yeah.
But please, huwag kayong maglagay ng kulungan dyan. Huwag kayong maglagay ng mga headquarters sa mga opisina dyan. Just leave it for conservation, please.
Actually, to close this, you make a good point that just because you own the land and you have a title to the land, doesn't mean you can do what you want with the land.
In a protected area.
In a protected area.
Because there are laws. Yeah, there are very strict regulations and there are zoning for strict protection and for multiple use. Pag multiple use, mas maluwag. Kasi nga, as the title would say, multiple use pwedeng gamitin. Pero meron din pinagbabawal po sa multiple use. Hindi naman pwede yung nakakasira ng ating kalikasan. Babalik tayo sa titulo. Babalik tayo sa intent ng batas. Enhance biological diversity. Sa simpleng salita sa Filipino, para mapaganda ang ating kalikasan. Huwag payagan ang paglalabag ng tao para sa ating sariling kapakanan. Simple po eh, ang pagkalbo ng bundok, ang pagputol ng mga bundok, ang paninira ng lawa at ng ating karagatan, hindi po makakabuti sa tao, sa pagkain, sa kabuhayan. Kaya kailangan proteksyonan.
All right. Now, Senator, of course, there will be more hearings on this, so I do hope to have you back on the show. But very quickly, I know that the Venice Biennale, which goes on every year, that you initiated, you will be opening it this, I believe, April 18, 16 to 18, if I read it correctly. Tama ito. What can we expect just before we go with the Venice Biennale this year? And why is this important?
Yes, after 51 years, the Philippines was absent from the Olympics of Contemporary Art in Venice, Italy. So in 2015, we successfully brought it back at the time. And since then, we've been participating, the Philippines, in a pavilion. And this year, on April 18, will be the vernissage, or the opening of the Philippine Pavilion. Alternately, it is art and architecture. It is important because it shows the creativity of our curators, of the Filipino artists. It speaks, it allows the Filipino to speak to the world and have conversations with different artists. It's nabuhay po ang ating contemporary art sector at nabibigyan ng halaga, nabibigyan ng boses, nabibigyan ng pagkakataon ang ating mga curators, hindi lamang yung mga kilala na at sikat na mga artists, even those who are up and coming. So we're happy to collaborate with the National Commission on Culture and the Arts and the Department of Foreign Affairs in supporting the Philippine participation in the Venice Biennale. But before we go, Karen, I hope you give me the opportunity to also greet our Filipino Muslims in the Philippines and abroad, all Muslims, sa araw na ito po ng Eid al-Fitr. Ako'y nakikiisa po sa inyo, sa ating mga kapatid na Muslim, sa lahat ng panig ng ating mundo, na sana po'y patuloy ang ating kasaganahan at kapayapaan. Kaya isang araw ng pagpala at kapayapaan po sa ating mga kapatid na Muslim. Eid Mubarak.
On that note, I want to thank you for joining me this morning, Senator Lauren Legarda. Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you very much, Karen. Maraming salamat.